Now, Western Scouts finishing up their survey of Iowa en route to Rochester, Minnesota. And as Agnes Michelle Rook joins us, Michelle, Scouts saw just about everything in Minnesota.
Despite heavy rains and flooding here in southern Minnesota to start off the growing season, USDA is projecting corn yields for the state to be static with last year at 185 bushels per acre and a slight uptick in soybean yield to 49 BPA. But how does that compare to what Pro Farmer Crop Scouts are finding out here on the tour?
Field after field in southern Minnesota shows the scars from record-setting rains and flooding right after Father's Day.
In the county around here, from 19 to 30 inches of rain by the before the 1st of July.
Some farmers lost entire fields and most of holes within fields and yellow corn.
So there's some drown out spots where guys came back in and either planted just a cover crop or put in some early beans just to fill the hole essentially.
Tilster had just 12 inches of rain, but is still concerned about nitrogen loss on corn.
We just don't know how stuff's gonna finish out with the leaching of our products out in the field.
To make things worse, Willer's crops are now drying out.
Now we're dealing with tipback corn, like yay.
And that's not because of the heat.
And that's because of the drought on top of all that rain, yes.
That's also meant flat bean pods, and so yield potential on both crops may fall below his APH.
Looking like 175, 80, which we should have 2.25. And soybeans, I don't know. If we're lucky to get 50 and they should be 60 plus.
So achieving USDA's projected yields may be difficult, but what did crop scouts find in the fields on corn?
I mean, the ears are definitely smaller. This is probably one of the best ears we've seen here. This stop was in the 160s. Our first stop was 110. And then, you know, it's been in between there.
And what about beans?
The first couple stops were, you know, a little bit low on the pod counts. You could tell that they were planted late. They'd had a lot of water. The plants were really thin, not a lot of pods, a lot of tubing pods, really flat yet. So just kind of immature and behind.
But the final results won't be known until harvest. I'm Michelle Rook reporting for Ag Day.